Okay, I tried to explain this in class and did a very bad job of it. I will be doing it in class again, but this is a little video to, if you ever get lost or forget some of the ideas, you can revisit this subject. And the idea was about, we were talking about servo assistance. Why is it doing that? Let's try again, pens. Okay, the idea we're talking about servo assistance of drum brakes. And we said that with a disc brake, we don't have this idea of servo assistance. And what is servo assistance? In a nutshell, it is where the brake actually, the brake design itself assists in the braking. Put very simply, with a caliper brake, you have to apply quite a large amount of force, and the brake doesn't help you in the braking situation. With a drum brake, the actual brake, the way it operates, you apply less pedal effort in a drum brake. So that's one of the great things about a drum brake. There's other advantages as well, but the disadvantage is at high speeds, our disc brakes outperform our drum brakes. But you will still find cars with drum brakes on the rear because our disc brakes at the front do about 70% of the work, and our drum brakes are a lot less maintenance, and they're a closed system so they don't get dirt in them, etc., etc. So there is advantages and disadvantages which we discussed in class. But servo assistance is basically just the brake design itself, meaning less pedal effort needs to be applied because of the operation. Less effort. Okay, so to understand this explanation, the first thing we need to talk about is friction. And we haven't done the whole idea of frictional coefficient and all that sort of stuff. We will get into that, but I'm not going to try and do that now. We do know that if I apply a force of effort on this box, on this surface here, and say the box is 10 kgs, then we need to overcome some sort of force to get the thing sliding. We've all been there. If something's not on wheels, you need to push it, and finally it starts to slide. Well, you're fighting a force which is called friction force. We all know what that is. We've all dealt with it in the past. So friction force, and that's a really good thing to sort of discuss when you're talking about a brake. Okay, so we've discussed how a drum brake works. A drum brake has our rotating drum on the outside. A contracting band would go around that drum, but in this instance, the pads are on the inside of the actual drum. So we have our curved brake pads. I sometimes call it a shoe, a brake shoe. Let's call it a brake pad, but okay. And we have an actuator that pushes this way and this way, usually hydraulics. That would be a slave. This black box here would be a slave cylinder. And it would be pushing a hydraulic ram that's connected to these pads. And the pads would be pushed out and onto the edge of this brake drum. So we're going to say that that's the slave cylinder of our drum brake. This is our drum that rotates, and these are our pivots. So that's what we pivot on. And our rotation is this way, okay? And in this discussion, we were talking about the leading edge, or the leading pad, having an advantage over the trailing. So let's look at our trailing pad first and try and find out why our trailing pad, which is the back pad on the left-hand side, why it's less efficient, okay? So you need to start thinking about the idea of frictional force being a reaction. So let's just do a little picture of a section of what's going on. When we actuate our brake, our pad pushes up against the actual drum, and the drum is still rotating in this direction. Okay, so we've pushed this way, and we've pushed up against the drum, and this is our rotation. So we're hopefully all understanding that part of the description, So we know that our friction force is a reaction. So the friction force on the actual drum, okay, is going in this direction, the opposite direction of the rotation, okay? So that's friction of the drum. But there's also a friction operating on the actual brake pad, okay? So this is where you need to do a little bit of a mind experiment, okay? So if you were to say, let's pretend that instead of the actual drum rotating, the pad is moving in reference to the drum. And so in that instance, if you were to think of it with that idea in mind, your pad is going in the opposite direction to the rotation, okay? Because it's sitting still while the drum goes past it. So pad motion is that way. And we all know that frictional force is a reaction force. So if our pad motion is going in this direction, we can think of the friction force on the pad, okay, is going in the opposite direction. So that's friction force of the pad, okay, the brake pad. So can you do you notice now that our actuator is going, and I'm just our actuator, and I'll do a circle around it here. That's our actuator direction, and our friction force is going in the opposite direction. Okay, so there'd be a component, because you know you can break up a force into its vectors. There'd be a component of this friction force that's on the pad that's fighting the actuator force. Okay, so that is why in the trailing edge pad, friction force opposes the actuator force, okay, the slave cylinder force. So slave cylinder is pushing this way, but the friction force on the pad is operating against it. And that's what makes the braking less efficient on our trailing edge. So that was our trailing edge scenario. So let's look at the other pad, which is, I'll just change colors here. Where are we? Colors. Let's go a bit of red. So that description I just did then was for this one here, okay? And that's the trailing edge. So now what we're going to do is we're going to do our leading edge scenario, and we're going to see that in the leading edge scenario, the actual frictional force is assisting the actuator. So let's change our color again. Let's do our leading edge in blue. So in our leading edge, we still have the we're going to draw a section of the brake drum. And then we have the other pad, which is the one we've just done the square around, and it's being pushed up against the edge of our drum. The rotation is still in this direction. And so we know that if that's rotation, then drum friction is that direction. So that's drum friction. Drum friction is in the opposite direction. And we know if the rotation is that direction, then if we're thinking about pad direction, or the pad force, if we're thinking about the drum being stationary, then we can say that our pad motion is in the opposite direction to rotation. So our frictional force is here. Can we see that there? Friction force. Friction force of the pad. And look at the direction, understanding that our actuator force is pushing in the same direction. So in this instance, for the leading edge scenario, friction assists the slave cylinder or actuator, whatever you want to call it, okay? Force. So we have a situation where forces are going in the same direction. They're helping each other. So that is why our trailing edge brake shoe or brake pad doesn't work as well as our leading edge one. Hopefully that's helpful. And like I said, I will explain it again in class, but at least you've got something that you can go back to have a look at and think about.